Hey there! In this short introductory video to yFiles for HTML, I'm going to show you one option for starting to work with our diagramming library. We'll be creating a new basic web app using Yeoman with ES6 modules and modern JavaScript with Webpack for the development. Of course, this is just one possible scenario to get started. Please see the other screencasts for alternatives. I already downloaded the yFiles package into my documents folder, and I'm going to start by opening my shell. And in this video, I'm going to create a new application. So now let's create a directory. And we're going to use Yeoman for scaffolding the basic application. You can install Yeoman using npm or yarn. I'll be using yarn in this case. So, and once yarn is installed, I can install a generator, which is the tool that will help me scaffold my application. There is a generator available online, and that's the yFiles app generator. So this generator has support for scaffolding applications using ES6, TypeScript, Webpack, and all kinds of third-party frameworks. So just play with it, and there's new options being added to it every time. So now once we've installed the generator, let's run it. It will first ask me for the application name, which is GraphApp in this case, which is fine. And then I'll need to tell it once where to find my library. So I'm going to just copy over the path to the unzipped contents of the emulation version. And I'm going to paste them over here. And it will also ask me for the location of the license. And then the first important question is whether I'm going to use UMD modules for loading the libraries or ES6. Module loading. In this case, I'll be using ES6 modules. And now I get the option to choose from the various available modules. Let's check the layout. One layout module. We'll need to use the bridge, and we want to use the editor. We can always add more later that, but let's start with this set of modules. So we'll be using ES6 for this application. And I would like to create a WebStorm project file to ease development. And for the development service, I'm going to use yarn. So after I told it what to do, it will go and fetch Webpack as the development server. And once it's done, I can open WebStorm to actually take a look at the sources. So this is what happened. It created the application. There's actually already a running version of the app, so just see what happens after running it. Yeah, that's a nice little application. And now let's open that using our IDE. So this is WebStorm. Let's just open the directory. So let's go to the documents. To the project that I just created. Now wait for WebStorm to load. Using WebStorm has several advantages because we provide code completion utilities, so that's why the initial start will take some time to load. So let's see what the module looks like. So that's the application. It's within the app folder. There's a dist folder which contains the build and application. There's a library folder which contains all the yFiles library files. And there's the scripts that contain the files we are going to work with. Of course, there's also a folder for some CSS files and the main index.html file. Most importantly, there's also a package JSON file. Let's see what options it brings. So there's obfuscate, production, dev, and start. Let's start with dev. See what happens. This will actually run the Webpack dev server, launch the browser, and build the Webpack bundles for us. So, looking at the sources, these are the main things that are required to get a yFiles app up and running. Start with the index.html file. The file loads the CSS file, which contains the basic default styling information for the controls that we provide. And of course, it loads the JavaScript that contains the application. In this case, it's a bundle created by Webpack, and the bundle contains both the library itself and our app in this configuration. So basically, that's all you need to actually run a yFiles app. As you can see, there's also one div element over here, which I've given an ID, and it also got some styling, so it has some initial size. Then, of course, there's the app.js file, which imports the various modules using ES6 imports. It also defines the license. And then there's this very simple application. So your app may have more sources or potentially third-party libraries. And if everything has been set up properly, you should get a working code completion, which is really something you should have enabled. And if it doesn't work, spend that extra bit of time to find out what's wrong with it and get it to work. So if you're going to click fetch documentation, yeah, then you might run into a bug like I've run into. A bug that it exists in the current version of WebStorm, where the definition file isn't set up properly. So let's take a look. What's important is to have the JavaScript library defined. This is what the scaffold already does for us. So, and it contains a reference to the TypeScript definition files over here. Even if you're not creating a TypeScript application, you should be using it because it provides the best possible code completion once it works. So, but if it doesn't, one trick currently is to just open the file and force WebStorm to reparse the file just by, well, add some space somewhere, hit save, and close it, and then wait for it to re-index the next time. You should get a working code completion like this. It takes a while, obviously, but now that we have it, we get code completion for all the properties, which is linked, and you can scroll through it, and for the various methods, nodes. So let's go through them. So this is our little application, which is a simple ES6 class, and we do nothing but instantiate that class, and in the constructor the initialize method is called. The initialize method actually instantiates the graph component, and it takes a reference to the CSS selector, which references the div element over here. And after this line of code is executed, the div over here will contain the graph control in the application. Once you have the graph control instance, you can get the the graph, which is the model in our control. And using the model, you can actually populate the graph using calls like create node, create edge, and so on. And so with two nodes over here, we can actually create an edge. And we actually want the user to be able to edit the graph on the screen. So we also set a corresponding input mode, which in this case is the graph editor input mode, which allows us to edit the graph. And finally, just for the purpose of showcasing the functionality, we are also choosing a layout algorithm and applying a morphing animation to get a nice layout of the graph that we just created. This is actually returning a promise, and that's what the warning is about here. So we can, if you want to, we can simply await that call, and then do some alert in the end. So let's see what happens. So this is the application. And as you can see, the graph is editable. We can create new elements, create edges, and so on. So that's for the application. So yFiles for HTML doesn't have any dependency on third-party libraries, but it works great with frameworks like AngularJS and Angular, or Angular CLI, or maybe even React or Vue.js. But you can also use the simple low-level tools like jQuery, Bootstrap, D3, etc. So there are demos in the packet that show how to do all of this, but it's important that you don't need all of this, but you can start with a very simple HTML file set up in JavaScript with no external dependencies. So this is only the tip of the iceberg of the features that you get if you're using yFiles for HTML. So go and give it a try today. Play with it. Thank you.